Hello students, today we will start numericals for multiplexing. The example is, assume that a voice channel occupies a bandwidth of 4 kHz. We need to combine 3 voice channels into a single link with bandwidth of 12 kHz. The total bandwidth is 12 kHz as individual devices need 4 kHz and there are 3 devices, 3 voice channels. The range is given from 20 to 32 kHz. We have to demonstrate this example with the help of figure. So the figure will be from first telephone, from the second, from the third, all are having the same frequency 4 kHz. The first bandwidth that is occupied from 20 Hz for first telephone, that is 20 to 24 Hz, for second 24 to 28, and for third 28 to 32. In this way they will not interfere each other and they will be combined by the multiplexer. By the multiplexer, the bandwidth will be 20 to 32. It looks like a single link. It looks like a single voice channel, but the channels are separated by the separation, that is 4 kHz gap, 4 kHz gap. At the demultiplexer end, again, there is the dark circle, that black circle, indicate demultiplexer. It separates each multiplexed or each modulated signal 20 to 24, second 24 to 28, 28 to 32. And this 24 to 28, these are modulated signals. These modulated signals are then separated from the carrier wave. The original wave is of 4 kHz, it is passed to the user. So in this way, the communication is feasible with frequency division multiplexing. Next is, 5 channels each with 100 kHz bandwidth are to be multiplexed together. What is the minimum bandwidth of the link if there is a need for a guard band of 10 kHz between the channels to prevent interference? So students, look, here each channel need 100 kHz and we have 5 channels. It means at least we need 500 kHz. Now we have to maintain a gap between individual channels. There are 5 channels, there must be gap. We should need 40 kHz for the gap. So we can represent it, for 5 channels we need at least 4 guard bands. This means that the requirement of bandwidth is 5 into 100, that is requirement at least 500. But here we have to maintain the guard band also. So between 5 channels we need 4 guard bands, that is 4 into 10. So total bandwidth requirement is 540 kHz. By diagram we can represent like this. I hope the concept of guard band is clear to you. Next one, this is analog hierarchy. Today we are not using this. We will use time division multiplexing, because in today's era all the telephone communication is based on analog, or you can say analog plus digital communication. So at some place there are analog communication, after some point it converted into digital to analog, and so on. Maybe at some place they are converted into again wave division, or they are converted into optical signals. So in this way today's era telephone communication is visible, but this diagram indicate the typical frequency division multiplexing. Here initially 12 voice channels are multiplexed by the first multiplexer, and this single line is called group. 12 devices are multiplexed on a single line. It means it carries 4 into 12, that is 48 kHz bandwidth. The group data carry 48 kHz data. Here 5 groups are there. So next multiplex unit is called super group. That is 5 into 48, that will be 240 kHz. Next super groups, that are 10 super groups are multiplexed together to make a master group, and so on. Here if we multiply 240 into 10, it becomes 2400. It means 2.4 megahertz. But now the master groups single line indicate 2.52 megahertz. It means the difference indicate there is some guard band concept implemented at the multiplexing point of super groups to make it a master group. Next one is last stage is that master group, six master groups are combined and it makes a jumbo group. So again, if you multiply 2.52 into 6, the answer will differ, as we have jumbo group is 16.984 megahertz. So the difference indicate there is again the implementation of God band, means empty bands. So this concept was implemented in the initial stages of telephone communication. Now we are using TDM at some places. At some places we are using WDM, and at some places we use FDM. So it's a mixture or combined concept of all these multiplexing techniques in today's telecommunication era. Next one is applications of FDM frequency division multiplexing. First one is AM radio, as I told earlier also in previous video. FM radio 88 megahertz to 108 megahertz. AM radio band is 760 kilohertz to 1140 kilohertz. The individual channels in AM radio, they are differed by simply 10 kilohertz gap. Means the God band in AM radio is 10 kilohertz. 10 kilohertz minimum gap hoga do channels ke beech mein. This 10 kilohertz is calculated as our voice is of 5 kilohertz. The gap is maintained twice of the human voice. So 10 kilohertz gap is maintained in AM radio. In FM radio, I already told you, FM radio, it maintained 10 times the original voice. So in FM radio, we consider 20 kilohertz, the maximum frequency that can be generated by human being, that is 5 kilohertz, and by instrument that can be 20 kilohertz. So 20 into 10, that will be 200 kilohertz or 0.2 megahertz. In television broadcasting, each channel need 6 megahertz bandwidth. So this bandwidth indicate the gap between two channels. First generation mobiles, they use 30 kilohertz. 30 kilohertz is, again, they have calculated it, 3 kilohertz. At that time it was considered human voice, but actually it may be 5 kilohertz, maybe 4 kilohertz. 3 kilohertz human voice is multiplied by 10, it means they maintain 30 kilohertz bandwidth gap between two users. At that time, 30 kilohertz gap was maintained for individual user channels. So first generation mobiles also used FDM. Next one is wave division multiplexing. When we use optical fiber use optical signals, and optical fiber is very costly, so we can utilize its efficiency. So wave division multiplexing is used to combine multiple optical signals. Here the figure indicates some symbol like lambda. It is not clear in your figure, but assume at lambda 1, lambda 2, for the second, third one, lambda 3. In lower classes, you have studied about the concept of wavelength and frequency. Lambda is equal to C by F, where is C is the speed of light, F is the frequency. So lambda is equal to C by F. If we understand the concept, wavelength is indirectly proportional to the frequency, or frequency is indirectly proportional to the wavelength. So wave signals, optical signals, are analog signal of very high frequency. So we use wave division multiplexing when we use optical signals. First thing is this. So using a fiber optic cable for one single line, it weighs the available bandwidth of the optical cable. Wave division multiplexing is same as FDM, but the multiplexing and demultiplexing concept involve the optical signals that are transmitted through the fiber cable. So students, in lower classes, I think you have done the prism experiment for combining or splitting the white light into multiple colors and multiple colored line into white line. So wave division multiplexing implement the same concept here also for combining multiple optical signals to make it a single signal. Here you see here L1, L2 and L3. It is not L1, L2, L3. There was some problem at the time we designed this PPT. assume this L1 as a lambda 1. Lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. We have three optical signals, each having different wavelengths. So three optical signals are combined in such a way that each have different wavelengths, and three optical signals are combined with the help of a multiplexer. Here the multiplexer is a prism. The same prism that you have used, but it is technical as compared to that you have used in lower classes for the experiment. So the multiplexer is a prism and the multiplexer is also a prism. So the concept is very simple. You can understand it very easily, but the implementation is very different. So this multiplexer and demultiplexer unit combine optical signal from different sources to make it a single optical signal, so that not any of the optical signal combine with each other. At the demultiplexer end, it split the single optical signal into multiple optical signal depends upon the wavelength. So combining and splitting of light sources are easily handled by a prism. So technology is complex, but the idea is very simple. Next is time division multiplexing. We start time division multiplexing. First thing, what are time slots, frame, we will discuss what is interleaving, what is synchronization, bit padding, digital signal services, and T-lines. Inverse TDM we will also discuss. So initially, what is time division multiplexing? Students, if we heard about twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, both these cables can transmit analog signal as well as digital signals, right? So analog signals, if we are using with these cables, twisted pair cable or coaxial cable, we use frequency division multiplexing. But if we transmit bits, means we are sending digital signals. We are sending bits in the form of digital signals, then we need time division multiplexing. So time division multiplexing is a digital process that allows several connections to share the high bandwidth of a link. Here we have four computer system at multiplexer end and four at the demultiplexer end. Here at the cable end, they represented four slots, one in white, one in pink, and one in yellow. In the white link, we have four slots, same for the next pink, again four slots, and in the yellow, again four slots. Means these single color, the single color indicate one frame. The single color indicate one frame, and one frame have four time slots. It is same as the reserved seat of a bus or a car. For example, there is a car and we have four seats available. If we have four neighbors and each have to send one student to some coaching center, we can make a reservation for each student in the bus or car. So this white color frame, white or pink color frame, if we consider pink color frame, this is our car. Individual students are seated from individual house. The car is single, but we are sending four students. Here, the capacity of the car was four, and if we send only one student, the capacity is wasted. In the same way, if the cable has higher bandwidth, we can multiplex multiple bits from various sources. So here, four devices are there. So four devices send single bit. In this example that they have demonstrated in here, one bit from each source, 1, 2, 3, 4. This combines unit, either it is pink or it is white, one color indicate a frame. At the demultiplexer end, individual bits are passed. Time is shared in TDM. At frequency division multiplexing concept, frequency was shared. Here time is shared. Digital data from different sources are combined into single time shared link. Data rate of medium should be greater than the bit rate of all devices whose data is to be transmitted. So data rate, this is the main thing. If each data device need 100 kbps speed individually. For example, first device need 100 kbps, second also need 100 kbps, third and fourth. It means we need a cable that need at least 400 kbps speed, then only we can make this time division multiplexing concept feasible, right? So four devices, 100 kbps each device required. So four devices, 4 × 100. So the link, the line or the cable must have the speed that is the combined requirement of all the devices. So again, I'm repeating the same line. Data rate of the medium should be greater than the bit rate of all devices whose data is to be transmitted. Bit rate, again, they taken the example same. Here, 1 Mbps, 1 Mbps, 1 Mbps. Each device needs 1 Mbps. Means in 1 second, they need to transmit one bit. If we have to transmit one bit from each device, it means our communication channel must have 4 bit per second data rate. So in time division multiplexing, the data rate of the link is n time faster and unit duration is n time shorter. Here four devices are there. So the time slots are four. Time slots, students, this one single column of white color is indicated as time slot. Four time slots of white color indicate one frame. Again, each pink color indicate this is one time slot, and four time slots combined makes a next frame, that is frame number two. Same for next yellow, this is frame number three. So time division multiplexing is a digital multiplexing technique to combine data. For example, four channels are multiplexed using TDM. If each channel send 100 byte per second, and we multiplex 1 byte per channel, means we are taking 1 byte per channel at a time. Show the frame traveling on the link, the size of the frame, duration of the frame, and frame rate and the bit rate. So students, this is a numerical problem. 100 byte per second, it means at least we need 100 byte into 4, that is 400 byte per second speed of the medium. And 400 byte, 1 byte is equal to 8 bit, so 400 into 8, that is 3200 bit per second. We have converted here the data rate into bit per second. Now student, we need to transmit 3200 bit per second, or we can say 3200 bits in 1 second. So the duration of the bit means in to transmit one bit, how much time it will take, that is called the bit duration, that is called bit duration. So bit duration is 1/3200 bit per bits. Frame duration, suppose we have to transmit 3200 people, and in one vehicle we can transport 32 persons. Means we have to transport 3200 bit per second. So 3200 are the number of items. In one vehicle we can put 32 items. So we need 100 vehicles. In the same way, if we are considering here 32 combined units in one vehicle, so this vehicle can be called as a frame. So here, this one frame size is equal to 32 bits. So how many frames we need? 32 bit per second divided by size of the frame, that is equal to 100 frames. So this is number of frames we need to transmit per second. Next part. So we will again see the question. Size of the frame is 32 bit. Duration of a frame means if we have to transmit 3200 bits in 1 second, and one frame contains 32 bits, so the number of frames 100. So one frame take 1/100 second. The frame rate is 100 frame per second. Bit rate is 3200 bit per second. I hope the question is clear. Next one is, in this diagram, all the devices are not ready with the data at each time slot. For first frame, the device one have A1 for first frame, second device have nothing to send. For first frame, the third device have something, that is C1. Frame 1, that is completed, but the slot is free. Means if we have made a reservation for 4 or 3 students in one car, if one is not going on that day, the seat will be further reserved, means it cannot be allotted to someone else. So in the same way, the slot is fixed. If devices have nothing to send, the slot will be empty and it goes as such. Next one is frame number 2. At frame number 2 time, the device A have A2, the device B have B2, and device C have nothing. So the third slot of the frame 2 will remain empty. It may be wastage of bandwidth, we will discuss it later on. Next one in frame 3 time, A have A3, B have B3, and C have C3. At this frame, we have all the devices have the bits or something to send. So this frame is complete. So each frame is having 3 time slots and each time slot duration is T second. So next one is interleaving concept. The same example we are considering here. In this example, we have a rotating switch. This rotating switch have gates. The gate get closed in front of the device at the multiplexer end. Suppose at the first frame time, this rotating switch get closed or the gate closed in front of the first device at the multiplexer end, and the first device have A1 to send. So this gate closed, it means the bit A1 is transferred, the data A1 is transferred on the line. Next, for B device, B have nothing to send. The gate is closed in front of the second device, but it have nothing to send. So the time slot will be empty. Next, the switch or the gate at the B device get open and close at in front of C. Whenever a gate get open, the connection release. Whenever gate is get closed, the connection established. So C have something to send for the first frame C1. So in this way, the frame is ready at the demultiplexer end. Reverse process is repeated. You can see the speed of both the switches. It is mandatory. They must be synchronized, but they must rotate in opposite directions. Here we assume the first device will send data to first device at the other end. Second will send data to the second device at the other end. Third device will send data to the third device at the other end. So there will be no switching. Means first device, if it want to send to third, in this chapter we will not discuss in detail. At switching concept we will discuss if there is a choice to change the change the source and destination. So at the demultiplexer end, the switch rotate in opposite direction. Again, it will the gate close in front of the first device. If it has something in the frame, A1 is there, so A1 is taken or passed to the first device. The gate again closed with the second device. It have nothing, but it get closed for the fixed time. The gate is closed again in front of the third device, and the C1 bit or the data is passed to the device. So interleaving is the concept that how the data is transported from individual device to the multiplexer or multiplex unit, that is called frame, and how the frame multiplex unit is demultiplexed or to pass the individual data to each device. So next we will discuss in next video. Okay, students, if you have any doubt, you can ask me individually. Thank you.